Yesterday, the Senate passed a resolution describing the Inspector General of Police as an enemy of democracy because he has failed to appear before the Senate. Will you agree with the Senate?
Absolutely and critically agree with House of Senate. Even not only enemy of the country, enemy of the government, enemy of the citizen, enemy of the constitution of the federation. Because according to the word of Bible in biblical quotation, Matthew chapter 10, verse 24 to 25, a servant stated it in that biblical quotation that a servant can never be greater than the master. Ibrahim, Idris, Potmo, or what is he call his name? He's a servant to the nation. But he didn't know that there's no difference between him and those people that they are working with Nigeria Railways Corporation. Because they are civil servants together, working with federal government. For Ibrahim Idris to disagree to appear in the House of Senate for almost 3 or 4 times that they are calling him into the Senate is a nonchalant attitude, embarrassment to the citizen of the country. Even they have to do the proper investigation, either the man is Nigerian or not. Because according to the section 214, that is the of the 99 constitution as amended, that is the law that they established Nigeria police force. Move to the section 216 of the 99 constitution as amended too. The president of the country can consult for the removal or the appointed the Inspector General of Police. The president must consult the Nigeria's Police Council and Police Service Commission. The Police Council and Police Service Commission properly recognized by the fact of Section 153 of the same 99 Constitution as amended under the Commission and Councils. For House of Senate, recognized by Section 65, voted for them, we have 109 senators in House of Senate. Even the House of Rep, as we have 360, they have right to summon anybody in this country according to the law of the Federation, according to the Section 62 and Section 68 of the same Nigerian Constitution as amended. Section 68 gave a power to the Senate House to pass a resolution and to do the proper investigation to authenticate the veracity of empirical reports and the implication of what Idris are doing to the nation. By the virtue of those laws, they have to quickly send a signal to the Senate because if they refuse to do that in time, Ibrahim Idris can do other things else. Because the man is now proof himself as if that's a gargantuan law of the Federation.
The penalty for contempt of the Senate is failure to appear.
Quickly remove Idris in immediate effect to pass a resolution and present it before Senate President. What Idris Ibrahim is doing now is violation of the fundamental right of the citizen of this country, the new citizen.
Are there any legal justification? Is it justified legally based on the provisions of the Police Act?
The Police Act is, I always read it all the time, based on their constabulary mentality. For IG to pronounce that Police Act, who made that Police Act, who ratified it, is it Police Act enormous or elevating than Nigeria Constitution? The man, he didn't know what he's saying. He didn't know. Because he's a lawless man. He's not deserved to be the IG of this country. You are quoting the Police Act. What law says, what Ibrahim Idris is saying, is a perturbing statement. It's uncalled for, it's illegal, it's a statement that is dirty from the mouth of someone that is half sensible to apply with decorum.
How much damage will this do to our democratic system if it is perpetuated?
100% damage for Nigeria, because I said it earlier that there's no any law enforcement agency that have capacity to effect arrest of anybody. By the fact of that Section 214, it is only Nigeria police that have capacity. By the fact of Section 33, Subsection 1A, B, C, subsection 1 and 2 A, B, C, give an opportunity to the police to arrest in order to suppress the tension of the situation, to monitoring the situation of the person that is sought to involve as a victim, to do not commit murder or to do not die in the scenario. But they have turned the thing into another thing entirely now. When you see the head of the ministry that is refused to follow the rule of law, you will see a lot of atrocity. See what Ibrahim Idris said since 2-3 months ago now. He said that they allege him that they have an amorous affairs or illegal relationship with those young lady in police service. He said that I have right to do. He deserves to go. He deserves to send him to the jail for that statement alone. It's an indecent assault in the criminal code. They have to remove the IG in immediate effect because he has serious implication to the country, to the democracy, and to the citizen of the country. If it's a great and corrosive embarrassment before the nation, I don't even know why the House of Senate are still waiting. Who are they waiting for? They have power to send. It's one third of the majority to send a paper to the Senate president. To send the president, to send it to the president, to the president must send it to the Nigeria Police Council and to remove the man from the place.
Thank you very much, Afarevu.
Thank you, sir.